Good morning, students. So in the last video we have seen data types, different types of data types and constants. So now we are going to see operators and expressions. Operators are like symbols. These operators are used to perform mathematical or logical manipulations. C programming language is rich with the built-in operators, and operators take part in the program for manipulating data and variables and form a part of mathematical or logical expressions. I'll explain with the help of examples. There are different types of operators. They are arithmetic operators are there, relational operators are there, logical operators are there, assignment operators are there, increment and decrement operators are there, conditional operators are there, bitwise operators are there, special operators are there. These are the different types of operators. We'll see one by one. First one is arithmetic operators. See, plus, minus, star, division, modulus symbols, right? These all are known as operators. Plus symbol is used for addition symbol. Is an addition operation, right? Minus is used for subtraction. Star is used for multiplication. Division is for division. And percentage is for modulus. I'll show the examples here. Int a is equal to 10. B is equal to 5, C is equal to A plus B, print of C is equal to percentage D, comma C. And define hostile debug, error is there, like, yeah. Error is there, right? So I went there and I edited. Again, I'll debug. There is no error. So I can run it. I'm running. I'll get the output C is equal to 15. This is my output. C is equal to 15. I got the output C is equal to 15. So plus is a arithmetic operator is used for addition. Go for minus. 10 minus 5 is 5, right? I got the output 5. So minus symbol is a operator used for subtraction. Like the star and division. Star. What is my output? It will be 50. I'll get the output 50. If you go for division, 10 by 5. I'll get the output 2. My output is 2. Then what is modulus operator? That's what I want to show you. Modulus operator, see. C is equal to 0. So what is the modulus operator? It will be giving remainder. 10 by 5. What is the remainder? 0 only, right? So if you take 10 by 3, what is the output? 10 by 3 output is 1. Why it is 1? Remainder is 1. When you divide 10 by 3, 3 is the answer and 1 is the remainder, right? So modulus operator is used to get the remainder. So these are the arithmetic operators. Then increment and decrement operators. Plus plus and minus minus are the increment and decrement operators. So I'll show the examples. I'll explain it. See, we'll take the same program. Okay. Control C. We'll take same program and I'll explain it. This handle don't mind. Okay. I'll hide all these things. I'll command. We don't want to see all these things. Huh? First, this also I'll hide. We'll take, I'll explain one by one. First, print of A is equal to percentage D. A plus plus. I have written A plus plus. In the A is equal to 5, B is equal to 5, A plus plus, and I'm printing A. I'm printing A. We'll see what is the output. Output is 6. What is the meaning of 6 there? 6 indicate A plus plus. A plus plus is equivalent to A plus plus is equivalent to A is equal to A plus 1. That is the meaning of A plus plus. So a is equal to a plus 1. A is equal to 5. 5 plus 1, 6. That 6 is assigned to a. That is the meaning of a plus plus. So take a minus minus. A minus minus 4. What is that? A minus minus is equivalent to a is equal to a is equal to a minus 1. So what is a minus 1? A is 5. 5 minus 1 is 4. So that is the meaning of a minus minus. So if you run, you will get 4. I hope you understood increment and decrement operators. This is one example for increment and decrement operators. When you execute, you will get this output. And next one is relational operators. These are the relational operators. Is equal to, not equal to, greater than or equal to, less than or equal to. These are the relational operators used to compare two variables. I'll show the examples. In the a is equal to 10, b is equal to 5. If a greater than b, I use that relational operators to compare two variables. If a is greater than b, this output is printing. So I'll be running. A value is greater than b value, so it is printed. Suppose my b value is 50. So a value is not greater than b, so it will not print. So this logic, this relational operator is used to compare two variables, and if the output is true, it will it can return either true or false. Now in this case, it is returning false value because a is not greater than b, so answer will be false. Hope you understood relational operators, which is used to compare two variables. Equal to is used to compare to check whether two variables are equal. Not equal to is used to check it whether two variables are not equal. Greater than is used to check whether the first variable is greater than second variable. This one is used to check whether the second variable is first variable is less than second variable. And these two are used to check whether the two variables are greater than or equal or less than or equal. Next two operators are logical operators. Logical operators examples are AND operator, OR operator, NOT operator. And these logical operators are used to compare two expressions. Like I'll show one example here. A is greater than B. And P is greater than D. Print hello. I have one condition. Condition is A should be greater than B and C should be greater than D. If both these condition happens, print hello. So see, I'll be printing hello, right? So AND is used to here, the first logical relational operator, there are two relational operators. I'll be using this AND, I'll be using with these two relational operators, right? If A is greater than B and C is greater than D, then only that it will be returning true answer, right? Suppose it is 100. I'll not get the output hello. Where I'll be getting? No, not 100. It should be 1. It should be 1. I'll not get the output of hello because A is greater than B, but C is not greater than D, right? So this particular thing will not return the true value. So I'll not get the output hello. So AND is like if the two variable, two side before one AND one expression is there, after AND one expression is there. These two expressions are true, then AND will return the true value. And OR value, any one is correct, it will return the true value. Here, if I give OR value here, OR value, A is greater than B or C is greater than D, I'll get the output hello. C is not greater than D, right? C is 1, D is 5. C is not greater than, but here I use AND, OR. So either this one should be true or this one should be true or both should be true. And next one is NOT. NOT operator, it perform logical negation or an expression. The next two operators are bitwise operators. So bitwise operators are C provides a special bitwise operator for bit operations between two variables. Like a bitwise operations. These are the operators. This one is used to perform binary left shift operation. This one is used to perform binary right shift operation. This one is used to complement. This one is used for binary AND operator. This one is for binary XOR operator. This one is for binary OR operator. And next two operators are assignment operators. Assign this 10, num1 is equal to 10. So 10 is assigned to num1. Like a plus equal to, I'll show here plus equal to. So, int a is equal to 10. A plus equal to a is equal to a plus 5. Print of a is equal to percentage d comma a. So a plus is equal to means a is equal to a plus 5. That is the meaning of a plus is equal to 5. This is the meaning of a plus is equal to 5. So that also one assignment operator. So increment then sign. This is decrement then sign. This is multiply and then sign. This is division and then assign. This is do the modulus operation and get the modulus value and then assign to the variable. This is left shift and assign. This is right shift and assign. This is do the bitwise AND operation and assign the value. This is do the bitwise OR operation and assign the value. This is bitwise inclusive OR and assign the value. These are the assignment operators. Next one is conditional expression. Conditional expression is, I'll show the example. I can write comma b is equal to 5. This is the syntax. Variable is equal to expression 1. Question mark expression 2 semicolon expression 3. Comma C is equal to A greater than B question mark A otherwise B. Print C. We'll see the output. What is the output? C is equal to percentage d comma c. Run. Where we missed something? No. Run. Output is 10. What is the meaning of this? If a is greater than b, then assign value of a to c. Otherwise, assign value of b to c. That is the meaning of this line. So, A greater than B. A is 10, B is 5, right? So, A is greater than B. So, assigning A value to C. So, I'll got the output 10. Suppose my input of B is 5. I'll get C value as 50. So, A greater than B. A is not greater than B, right? So, the second expression, B will be assigning to C. Hope all of you understood this conditional expression. Expression 1 and expression 2, then semicolon expression 3. Special operators. There are three special operators. Size of, ampersand symbol and star. Size of is used to check the return size of the memory location. This is used to check the return the address of a memory location. Star is pointed to a variable. This one we'll see in the last module. Size of and star, ampersand I'll show you here. Print of percentage d comma c comma c comma c comma c. Run it. 4. What is the meaning of 4? Size of A. A is a what is like a, what is the meaning of India is equal to 10? Reserve a memory space with the name, that memory space name is A. It can store integer value, that value is 10, right? Reserve a memory space. How much memory space you have to reserve? 4. For memory, 4 locations you are going to reserve, because integer, A is integer, that value of integer is 4. Suppose it is float. Suppose it is float. Then, see the answer.